it's Gleb here. Let's talk about black and white rendering, a creative idea for you folks. It is stylish, it is liberating as you don't have to care about, color. It puts tonal values and I guess lighting to the forefront of your artistic effort. And it obviously carries a lot of historical connotations as this style of rendering signifies a certain period of time and transmits a retro vibe, but also a certain timelessness. But most importantly, it just looks cool if you're into that type of aesthetics. I don't see a lot of black and white renders or, I don't know, Godot games made in this visual style, so maybe we can do more of that? Anyway, in Blender, to get a monochromatic render going, the first method I'm gonna show is just coming over to the color management tab. Actually, let me drag it to the top like that. So all you need to do is make sure you're in AGX and then click Look and select grayscale. That's all you need to do. And that would make it a black and white render instantly, both in the viewports and in the camera view, essentially. That's all. It has to be probably the quickest way to go black and white in Blender. Then you can adjust some exposure and whatever. That's pretty much the quickest we can do. Then let me show you something different. I'll reset it to the default look, and then get compositor opened in a separate window. First of all, we need to click use nodes, otherwise nothing will work. If you've paid me a dollar each time I forget to click it, I would have more than a dollar, I guess. Then to make it work in real time, we need to open this tab. By default, the real time compositor is switched off. All we need to do is select camera or always if you want it to work in the viewport as well. Then the hue saturation node instantly springs to mind. It's how we used to do it in Photoshop anyway. Shift A, color, hue saturation value, and drop this node into the chain like that. Then saturation obviously controls the overall colorfulness, so bringing it down to zero would suck all the color from the picture, so it turns entirely monochromatic, or black and white. Right, M mutes the node. The thing is, it would look different from the AGX grayscale mode we tried before. The difference would be quite subtle in this example, but still it is there. Why so? These two approaches use different conversion algorithms, and that's important. There are different ways to convert the color data from the red, green and blue channels into basically just one channel. That is a crucial thing to understand about black and white rendering. There is more than one way to do it. Let me show you something that you may find interesting. Here we have two spheres, a dark blue and a bright yellow sphere. The blue one being obviously darker than the yellow one, right? At least for me, but I think for you as well. Because blue is, well, blue is darker than yellow, isn't it? Well, it's a bit tricky. Let's apply the hue saturation node first to desaturate the contents so I can show you something. Look what would happen. It turns out that the blue sphere wasn't actually that much darker than the yellow sphere. What is this sorcery? Actually, in the absolute energy values, the blue light emitted by the blue surface is just as strong as the yellow light emitted by this other one, roughly. Even though yellow color somehow looks brighter to us humans. Actually, let me render it out so I can show you something. Okay, let's wait for the render to finish. If we right-click to sample the surface of the blue sphere, we'll see that the blue channel reads as roughly 0.58 or something. That's the power of the blue light as it's shown on the monitor. Then if we sample the yellow surface now, the reads out of the red and green channels will be more or less in the same ballpark. 0.6 something, not much stronger than the blue light indeed. So when the saturation is brought down, it just converts these values to, let's say, to the brightness without taking the perceptual weight into account. So to get a more perceptually correct black and white conversion, we should use not this node but something else, which could be RGB to black and white node in Blender, for instance. Let me connect it like that and look at the result. See how it corresponds to what we expect from blue and yellow in a more perceptually correct way that takes the color luminance into account. You see, yellow has a higher luminance, so this algorithm renders it lighter in grayscale. And conversely, blue has a lower luminance, so it ends up darker in grayscale. That's the RGB to black and white node. which you might say is a perceptually more correct method of doing a grayscale conversion anyway. To make this example even clearer, here it is in 2D, the blue and yellow swatches. This free web app is called Photopia, by the way. So if we apply the hue saturation effect from the list of the Photopia effects and desaturate the image completely, the swatches would become equalized in value to our frustration. Again, that's a blunt, non-perceptual method of converting color to grayscale. Then some other tools, like for instance, let's remove the hue saturation value filter and add the channel mixer instead, and switch the monochromatic mode on. So some other methods like this channel mixer may take the color luminance into account again. Here you can see that by default the different channels have different weights. Blue is 20% while the red and green contribution is significantly higher. Again, this kind of sorcery is what may be needed to make the grayscale conversion line up with our expectations about certain colors being darker or brighter. Let's have a look at DaVinci Resolve now. The saturation control in Resolve can be found over there, while working in the color tab, obviously. Unlike Blender though, or Photopia, the Resolve saturation does take luminance into account by default. In a bit different way, but still. So, we could just bring it down to zero and get a nice black and white image right out of the box, in theory. There is another control, which does a very similar thing, color boost. When it's brought down to zero, there's pretty much no difference. Yeah, so for the black and white rendering, these two could be used interchangeably. When it's close to zero, but not zero though, the color boost still leaves some color in the image. So it's like this nice selective saturation effect, where most of the image is colorless and only a few spots have a bit of chroma left. It reminds me of a super stylized movie called Sin City. It's almost this kind of effect. Now let me show you one more cool method of creating the black and white effect in Resolve. Basically, it can be accessed from within this tab in the color panel. We just need to tick the monochrome checkbox like that. After checking that checkbox, feel free to play with the RGB channel's contributions to change the black and white look dramatically. Like, it can totally change the appearance of the monochromatic render by giving more weights to different color channels. So you can see that we can aim for various results indeed by simply adjusting the channel weights. And that feature alone makes it a pretty powerful workflow for tweaking your black and white renders. The other really cool trick we can pull off is to add one more corrector node before the black and white filter, then come over to the good old color wheels tab and rotate, or let's say, adjust the hue of the original image that is still there underneath the monochromatic filter. Rotating the hue like that completely reshuffles the values or luminosity relationships within the image and is simply put a great tool for experimenting with the look of your black and white renders. I think that's super fascinating, how this simple trick helps to create different takes on how the final picture may look. Try it out and you'll see how it helps to bring certain areas and certain details in focus. It's just a very interesting effect to play with and a great artistic tool. The tool that hints at the cornerstone issue of black and white rendering, the issue of truth. If there are multiple ways of converting color to a monochromatic image, there is simply no truth. The right way to do it is to make it look right according to your artistic eye. You can resort to the perceptual methods, or you can use anything that works for you as an author, based on what you think is a great black and white image in the end. Actually, if you want to experiment with the different black and white looks, feel free to download the loot pack from our Gumroad or Patreon page for free. It has some pretty cool black and white looks alongside other things, like this one, which is a more traditional take, but also feel free to try the silver halide or its nuclear version for a slightly more unhinged take on this aesthetic. I would like to thank all our sponsors on Patreon and everyone who donated to our Blender to Resolve course. Dear Shrimps, you rock! And feel free to post some black and white renders on social media and tag us. And let us know in the comments what creative ideas would you love to see unpacked by us next.